Now, if you recall from the beginning of the lesson, we talked about three major ways to estimate value. One is intrinsic value, which we just covered. Another is book value, which we're going to cover now. And the other is market capitalization. So let's take a look at book value. Here's a classic definition of book value. It's total assets of the company. In other words, things like property that is owned and so on, minus intangible assets and liabilities. So intangible assets are things that are difficult to put a price on. They're things like the value of a brand or a patent or so on. Liabilities are a little bit easier to calculate. Those are just things like loans that are owed and so on. So let's consider what is the book value for an example company. Let's say the company owns four factories and that each of these factories is worth about $10 million. These are assets, and altogether they're worth about $40 million. Suppose this company also holds three very important patents, and each patent is valued at about $5 million. The value of these patents is about $15 million, but these are intangible assets that are hard to price exactly. Finally, suppose this company has one large loan. This would be under the liabilities column, of $10 million. If we follow this rule that book value is total assets, so total assets are this $40 million plus the $15 million, or $55 million, minus intangible assets. So we just don't count these intangible assets and liabilities. So altogether, we've got our total assets minus intangible assets, which is $40 million, and liabilities minus this $10 million. So in this case, this company's book value is $30 million.